The Year of Spectacular Men, not only a movie, it is a family affair. And thus, the triumphant return of Leah Thompson and her daughter, Madelyn Deutch. Lady, nice to
good
see you
morning.
Both.
Thank you for having
we
us
We sold the
again.
Movie!
You so congratulations! And, but you know what, for people who don't understand this, and I'll use a couple of phrases that are certainly familiar to you. There are a ton of movies that are quote-unquote in the can, completed films that are done, that then are done and just lie there.
Yeah.
Talk to us about this process.
Thank you for saying
yeah.
that.
Yeah. Yeah, thank you.
We love you.
Okay.
Well, it started almost, 5 years ago we started, Maddie started writing the movie, and then it took us like 2 or 3 years and different producers to find Parkside Pictures to find the money and make the movie. And then even after we finished the movie and got it in film festivals and got it bought, it took another year for it to come out now. Mm-hmm.
It's a long process, but we're really proud of the film. We made the movie we intended to make.
Yeah.
I think that's
and you know what? And I tell you what, that is a departure because often some producer will come in
yes.
and like, this is a really good idea. Could you throw in Mark Wahlberg?
Or, yeah.
You
know, yeah, exactly.
Or you're directed in some fashion.
We want Mark Wahlberg.
That's not hard to
have
Mark.
Yeah.
That's one of the things that's Mark. So nice about right. independent film because it's her vision. It's a movie about a young woman written by a young woman, and we pretty much, because we had such great producers and a wonderful director, we got to make that a really original idea actually happen, and it wasn't diluted. You
right.
know?
See, that's the thing.
Uh-huh.
That story. Talk, Madelyn, what does it tell? Remind us about what it's about.
Okay, so The Year of Spectacular Men is about Izzy Klein. She is a classic millennial. She gets out of college and doesn't know what she wants to do with her life.
Have you met my daughter?
Yeah, exactly.
Last time I was here,
there's a lot of
like,
people
can
like
you
this.
Talk to my daughter? I was like, no, I have no advice. I wrote a movie about it. That's the weirdest way to deal with this problem. It's about 5 guys she dates over the course of 1 year, and it's a really gnarly year. It's pretty gnar. And we do a lot of abbreviating, and there's a lot of it's heartfelt, it's earnest, and it's also funny, and we're the tone is ours.
Yeah,
the tone feels like our family.
Okay. Oh, I love to hear that. Let me look at a clip of it. Here we go.
I hear that you broke up with Aaron. I'm really sorry to hear about that. I wish you would have told me sooner.
I did. I left you like 74 voicemails.
No.
Dad, you do kind of go off the grid when you're on retreats.
I know.
Mom, how can that be more important than the quarter-life crisis I'm in the middle of?
Huh?
Seriously, I mean, you're her girlfriend for, a year, right? Can you do me a solid here and alert her to it, like her child is clearly suffering?
We're not girlfriends, honey. We're soul walkers. We're not defined by societal conventions. We're not in anything.
We're on a journey.
Oh, God! Oh!
But
we're on a journey.
You don't have icky friends like that in real life.
No. Well, that's Melissa Bologna. She's
okay.
a wonderful actress.
Right.
And
obviously.
Also, Zoe Deutch is in the movie. She's her real life sister who plays sisters.
She is?
Right. Yes.
She
is. So it's the first movie ever with sisters playing sisters
right.
and mothers directed.
Isn't that lovely?
Okay, then how's the mother daughter? We probably talked about this last time you were here, but a lot of mother daughters might go, oh my goodness, that's a different kind of situation to work with mom or to work with my kid.
We're mostly proud of the crew because, you
really?
Know, it could have ended in tragedy.
It was actually really, I think it says a lot about my mom that she's got so much goodwill in this town and has been working for so many years that, like, the crew, when they came on, they weren't really trepidatious about it. I think they trusted her already and sort of
and
felt she was in a great environment.
Aww. My kids trusted me, too. So it's been a really lovely process.
All right, and your chance to see the whole thing. The Year of Spectacular Men will hit select theaters. Here comes the prompter. And video on demand, that happens on June the 15th. You guys should do some Q&A screenings and stuff.
Yeah, we are, yes.
All right, well,
and
let us know.
And iTunes and Amazon. Right.
Yeah,
Emily
so
Santa
you'll be
Monica.
Able to find it.
Yeah, we'll let you know about all that. Good to see you guys.
Great, thank
Can't
you.
Get rid of us.
No.
Please come back.
Come back.
Journey, right?